Helter Skelter.
Yeah.
I've had that problem actually on a bunch of my guitars. I get these Kalers that are the same consistency. They got like the strings in back, so they have real good sustain. But it's got this little clamping thing that they have, which whenever the bar is like going down like this, and when it's doing that, you can't trim it anyway because you have to have it like this.
Right.
Whenever it's going down, it locks the original place. So you can mute and you can sit on the thing when it's moving. And also, when it's backwards, it unlocks. So you can do like the whole sort of stuff. When it's up, it's been, so the only place where it locks is when it's down.
So you're kind of a scalar fan with
the Yeah, those are real great. Although I just got like a stock Ibanez that's got one of the Airfoils in it. They've really improved a lot from when they first came out. They've made like the fine tuned pegs a lot longer so they actually do something. And they left enough wood in the back so the screws didn't like strip out. And so the thing's actually functional at this point. But you know, if you mute a certain way, it would still do it. I'm actually having a lot of luck with it. But the Kalers have definitely solved that problem.
Yeah,
hi. I think these two are like the ones that come with the evidence is the F somethings, like F2s or something. I see what I can distortion. And at the moment, it's doing something weird. I don't know what it says. It may have fixed itself. That's kind of close. It just, the last couple days, it seemed trebler than it should be. But then, I like, took it apart and kind of swooped that out. And, well, it's fine. I'll put it back together and accept that. There's one. Oh yeah, we see it all the time. Totally, it was like get up on the drum riser. I can't even remember it without one. Realized that I was really fatiguing the high E a lot, and so and I don't normally break strings, you know, since I hadn't used a drill before, so I always wouldn't even have to worry about it. I have a spare guitar, but I didn't like, really worry about it. And I broke a string, like third tune, and so I go, runs up, it's in the dressing room, we had to like bring it down to be right to be on stage, runs up, brings it back down, gives it to me, where's this? It's in the case! No, it isn't! And so he brings down another strap, but it's got the wrong kind of strap on it. So he takes duct tape and tapes it on. And it was one of those straps that you can't easily adjust. It was like, I've got to take this leather thing out and loop it to it. So I didn't have time to do that. So I got the things hanging down like below my knees. And Johnny Ramone style, and we're about to do Motorman, which is like, it's a real terrifying sweep thing. I can do the machinery as a punk rocker, and that's about it. And so I get about halfway through this tune, and the tape comes off. So the guitar's like on the ground. I'm kneeling down playing the thing. And, I'm trying to think of anything else going wrong with the show. I think I just about did it.
Is this
a Well, actually, it was a great roadie. It was just a bad vibe or something. Yeah, that was Troy. Do you know Troy? He's working for, I think he's working for Anthrax now. He's working for Testament for a while. He's working for Anthrax.
Did you play the solo on the Loud album?
Oh, let me see what this is. Best of Soul Blues is like in that 7/5. Natural minor looked, and a slight modification of it wasn't going to throw me off that much. That's a cool thing. The more you play guitar, the easier stuff gets because you've already kind of done it. Unless you just set it to the harmonic minor, and that's the way it goes. For me, anyway. I mean, that shapes that scare me to death. Although, that's melodic one, believe it or not. But I hit a lot of it. Yeah, it took me a long time to change the way I held the pick. I did at first, I just would sit there like, when I talk on the phone and just hold it the new way and just get used to holding it. It felt really weird. So I was used to using like, the flat part of my finger. When I went to the side, it's a lot less the finger that you're using. Plus, it was a whole different pressure. You know, if you hold it from the front, it's kind of pushing it up. Or if you hold it on the side, it's pushing it this way. And at first, it hurt. I was like, my finger's going this way. I don't like this. And after a while, it got you used to it.
I like having the accents, you know. Like, for instance, this is a
total, to me, sounds real four, real four, you know, like Yeah, again. again, it's hard for me to know what the heck to do because I don't have double jointed hands. I was like, I think I do.
Uh-huh. And I can usually play fast with like one or two fingers on the buildings or the lower frets down here and mm-hmm. hand here.
Well, yeah, I don't know. I'm confused. You've stumped me.
Were you in a cover band before Rites of Rags?
Hold on a second. What's that?
Were you in a cover band before Rites of Rags?
Oh, I was in a million cover bands before Rites of Rags. I used to do like, it was great because I get to pretend I was like all my favorite guitar players. I would come to rehearsal and go, man, guys, we gotta do DOA. It's like my favorite song of all time. And one night I get to pretend I was Eddie, Randy Rhoads, and like, Yes, Iron Maiden, Judas Priest, Alice Lyson, and we get to do Pet Travers and all my favorite stuff. Real cool for just learning how to work with a drummer and, how songs go and that sort of thing. Stuff like amp tone, playing loud, the whole thing was great. Didn't make any money, but I had a lot of fun performing a lot of stuff. Peloton stuff? That sort of thing. Not a whole lot of it, just because there were a couple of guys that were kind of known for doing that, and I figured I'd be better off trying to do other stuff. But I'm working on a little. I worked on just. Just to be able to play it, just the straight and stuff. But, my own stuff. Also, the Eric Johnson one is totally cool. The most fun way to do is two-handed because it's a million times easier. He's in Racer X, when the new band comes to big.
Oh, okay, well, he's in Racer X.
Right.
Let's see if we play.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
all
right,
I can't remember.
Who's in the band?
I can't remember whether it was you or another band, but how I read that, like, you would use your left hand to play something on another guitar and play this hand.
Oh, yeah, we used to, in Getaway, we used to do a solo or. We used to do the thing where I would pick and listen to the left hand part, and it was actually pretty easy because we both just wanted to solo both parts by ourselves, and then we just did the hand in the air thing. You know, I did the thing where if I had to pick this. It's like plugging two guitars into one amp. You know how they kind of cancel each other out. It doesn't work well. That's why, you know, like a lot of the Stanley Jordan stuff, which is totally great with clean sound. If you distorted it, it would be like it wouldn't mix well. Maybe if you had a stereo pickup, but you know, the nature of distorted guitar sounds, so when you play more than one string, it starts getting kind of messy.
Did you keep anybody from your old band?
Old new band. Although I got a similar last name, the new singer is Eric Martin. Not to be confused with Mozart and Jeff Martin. I really shouldn't have known.
Dang it.
Why did I leave Razor X? To do the new band. Razor X is a lot of fun. And, it's loads of fun, a really cool band, but I think this is gonna knock the people dead.
Didn't you like start Razor X? So, like,
yeah.
Going on?
I started it, but I didn't finish it. I didn't think of the name. When I heard it, I liked it a lot, but I didn't think of it.
They got some cars.
Yeah, they replaced me with a guy named Chris Arvan. Totally, totally right. He's really cool.
How much do you practice?
How much do I practice? Not enough. Lately, I've been doing a lot more TV watching. I just bought my first TV that I've like ever had. And so I just been going like, wow, I've never seen this episode of Gilligan's Island. So after another week or so goes by, I'll like be used to it. I'll see all the Gilligan's Islands and be bored. I'll get back to practicing guitar. But it takes some. There's a lot of different ways that I practice. There's a certain amount I have to do just to keep my technique. There's a lot of stuff that I'm doing more composing stuff, trying to come up with new licks and new phrases. There's stuff where I'm just practicing keeping my rhythm together. All that garbage. Figuring out tunes for words.
Practice an hour and a half a day, and I can't. I still don't think the building changed. When I first started playing, I think we're completely short here. And now I'm starting to
play. Loudness?
No. And now I'm playing like it was sleeping on, but I know all the chords and stuff. I still don't think I can change.
You want to run the pass beam. Make that shorter, and the pass beam more time. So you're playing an hour and a half a day?
I practice an hour and a half a day.
Okay, and what's the problem? Oh, really? Well, what do you practice? Do you practice things that you know or things
that... I practice first guitar
and then gameplay. Well, I mean, but do you practice new things? I mean, do you, like, sit down and go, well, let's see, I already can do this, so I need to get something else.
Well, the only thing I do is I listen to songs and sound
them
out.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I learned two new songs by just listening to
them. Totally, totally cool. Because that sort of stuff, that'll literally extend your playing, because a lot of times, you know, you may like figure something out, and you may not be able to get it exact, but the next time you listen to it, you'll get a better version, and your ear will keep getting better, and your fingers will get better at the same time. A lot of stuff that I figured out wrong at first, and then the three versions after that, you get real close. But just keep doing stuff by ear, and it'll help. Let's see. Something I've ever jammed with. Actually, there's one guy at. I mean, I jammed with a lot of guys at GITs, so they're all the time doing that. There's one guy named Marcus. It was really, really a lot of fun to play with. He's got a lot of cool progressions, and he actually taught me a ton, because he's really incredible with phrasing and stuff. And, we'd be playing some, and I'd come in with, do something terrifying, and he'd come in and play like two notes, and I'd be like, wow, you know, it's true. It's possible to make two notes sound really, really cool. You know, how do you do this? And then, so I learned a lot from him, really demonstrated it today, but it was plausible. This was probably the favorite guy. I played with him a whole lot. He's different all the time. I don't know if he's doing anything wrong. I think he's just trying to get his passport renewed or something. He's from Germany or one of those countries over there. I'm going to play.
When you and Cactus, you lost your left hand, would your left hand start bugging you because it wouldn't make the shape, like on a three-note string scales?
Like a harmonic minor, some of the shapes are
weird. Yeah, real weird, and your fingers start like, they don't want to do it.
Yeah, there's certain things, I definitely try to make life easy for myself, find shapes that are easy. Every once in a while to get the count tonality, I want to have to cheese around with it. But most of them are okay. I mean, the weirdest thing I have to do is like a harmonic minor. Sometimes I have to shift my third finger just because of the way I do whole steps. But for that one thing, I usually change it and end up using both fingers. So I just try like everything I can think of to play it. And if I still can't do it, I'll come with it. There's a lot of stuff you can do. Go to a different set of strings, which are tuned differently, because you take advantage of the fact that you've got that major third in there. There's a lot of things are figured differently that way. If I can't play it, I don't play it. Everything you've seen is. I can't think of any examples that you can. Oh, I see. But we can play like a few more things and get out of this hot sticky room and do something. Let's see. Oh, we gotta do a few name that tunes. That's a must. And the guys at the school, you can't answer because you've already heard this. Let's see, maybe that tune number one.
Thank you.
Thank you.